and he said, oh, well, it's all I was, and he said, well, it was so funny. I hear still to this day about it.
Well, I have to admire that, except if you're on the receiving end of that.
That's right.
Exactly. It's not quite so funny.
Okay, how are you doing? Did you get to talk to John yet? Oh, come on, come on.
No, he's a tall fellow there. The reddish.
This series of paintings of cities started in about 2003, and I had been doing landscapes that were from aerial viewpoints, but often of very small communities in the area that I lived in Georgian Bay. And as I, it was a very gradual process where I began to become more and more interested in the places where people lived, and a little bit less interested in the landscape in general. And it sort of mutated into larger and larger towns and then cities, because I became fascinated with the kind of overlay of roads and railroads and bridges and houses and factories that people build on a landscape to generate a city. Then I began to see the cities as very organic things, like almost like a human body, and sort of slowly developed a vocabulary for painting these things, exaggerating the size of the roads and the bridges to make them feel nice. And it sort of got to the point where I was really most interested in very, very large cities like New York, London, Montreal, and that's where the work is presently. I'm still sort of going back to cities that I found fascinating, or going to new ones that I think would be interesting, and going through the process of making sketches, taking photographs, learning what's there, and then figuring out a way to present it so it looks as a feeling of that particular city to it.
Distraction.